Hi, I'm Megan. Today we're going to talk about chocolate toxicity. Now, it's currently Halloween, but after Halloween comes Christmas, then Valentine's Day, then Easter. There are a lot of chocolate holidays. There are a lot of reasons that there's chocolate around all the time because it's delicious, and our dogs are going to get into it. We're going to see chocolate toxicities year round. Now, the methylxanthines are the kind of toxic proponent of chocolate, and they include caffeine and theobromine, and chocolate contains both of those. Chocolate is actually toxic to cats as well. We don't see as many cats who are interested in getting into chocolate, but there are certainly those out there that will eat what's in front of them. So if an owner calls and does have a cat that's gotten into a bunch of chocolate, it's worth noting that they can show the same signs of toxicities that dogs can. Now, as with any toxin, it's dose dependent. The methylxanthines, the toxic proponent of chocolate, there's going to be less of those in milk chocolate than there is in dark chocolate. And obviously, baking chocolate is the most dense and is going to have the biggest problem to our patients. So the signs are going to vary depending on the type of chocolate, the size of dog, and how much they ate. A Great Dane that eats 2 Hershey's Kisses, probably not going to be a big deal, but that 3-pound Chihuahua that gets into Hershey's Kisses, we may have an issue with that dog. So as you can see here, the signs of toxicity are going to occur at about 100 milligrams per kilogram of ingested methylxanthine. So you're going to have to figure out what type of chocolate it was, the weight of the dog, and then kind of put all that together. Milk chocolate contains about 60 milligrams per ounce. Dark chocolate is about twice that much at 150 milligrams per ounce. And then we go way up with a baking chocolate at around 450 milligrams per ounce. So when the owners call and there's an issue, make sure that you ask them if they know how much the animal ate and definitely what type of chocolate it is. The internet has a variety of chocolate calculators out there that you can put the weight of the dog, the type of chocolate, and how much they ate. And it will tell you if you can expect a mild, moderate, or severe reaction. Just make sure that if you're finding those calculators that you're looking on veterinary approved websites, and it's not just some Yahoo out in the country who's making up this chocolate calculator for you. So we'll tend to see signs in these patients about 1 to 4 hours post-ingestion. That's not a hard and fast rule, but that's about the time that you're going to start to look for problems. First, we'll see GI distress in these more mild reactions. These animals are going to be vomiting and probably have diarrhea. And a lot of that is just a result of everything else that goes into those treats that have chocolate in them. If your dog is eating brownies or cookies or cake, there's a lot of flour and butter and sugar, and that's all going to go in to cause GI distress. Some of these patients, we can see a problem with pancreatitis, so we may be able to get them through the chocolate part of it, but then we've got this prolonged kind of GI disease that we're dealing with. What really gets concerning about these guys is that the methylxanthines actually increase the calcium content inside the cell, and it increases cell excitability. So we start to see these muscle tremors, and we can actually start to see cardiac arrhythmias because of the chocolate that the animal has eaten. So this is a classic presentation of kind of a mild reaction. You may think, well, this is just a cute little dog and it looks like it really wants to get out of the kennel and be held. But this dog was behaving this way at home, really restless, panting, unable to lie down, just moving around all the time, seemed really excitable. This little dog had gotten into chocolate earlier in the day, and these are the kind of mild signs that we're going to see. If you look at the back legs of some of these patients, you'll be able to see that they're trembling a little bit. Those tremors can progress to seizures, which can progress to coma and death. So we definitely don't want to look at this and say, oh, that's a mild reaction, it's not that big a deal. When we start to see more of a moderate to severe reaction, we'll see tachycardia. So the heart muscle just gets really excited. We start to see this increase in heart rate. So this particular ECG shows a sinus tachycardia. So the ECG waves are normal. We have a normal rhythm. We just have a really high rate. Some of these patients can get up into a heart rate of 200, 220, 240. So it's important to have owners check the heart rate at home. And if they're noticing it a little bit high at home, definitely time to get them in and have them seen. We can start decontamination and treat them for their chocolate toxicity. This, as we're getting into a much more severe reaction, is called ventricular tachycardia. So this patient, we're seeing the arrhythmias, we're seeing VPCs all strung together at extremely high heart rates. This is definitely worth hospitalizing and monitoring this patient. And this is the danger that we see with these higher doses of chocolate in these patients. So when they come in, first step is decontamination. The sweet spot of inducing vomiting in these patients is to do it within about 1 to 2 hours of ingestion if possible. What I have learned about chocolate is that it kind of sits in the stomach for a long time. It can kind of form a little ball in there. So even if it's been multiple hours since the animal has ingested chocolate, it's worth inducing vomiting just to see if you can get some of that up. And a lot of patients like this one here, we'll see a lot of wrappers in there because they tend to just inhale everything. If the animal is, you know, seizuring, doing very poorly, ingested a very, very large amount of chocolate, it may be worth performing gastric lavage. It's safer for that patient for them to be anesthetized, protect their airway, and perform gastric lavage to get that chocolate out of their stomach. If it's been a prolonged period of time and you have a patient that's been hospitalized and they're still, heart rate is still high, you're still seeing arrhythmias, it's worth doing an enema to try and clear out as much as you can from the intestinal tract. So as technicians, monitoring our chocolate toxicity patients, or really any toxicity patients, if they're not improving the way we think they should be, think about an enema so that we can get as much of that out as possible. The next step after decontamination is to give some activated charcoal. The really small porous molecules in that charcoal, their goal is to just absorb toxins from the GI tract and kind of help them pass out without the animal absorbing them. You're going to start with a dose. Most of the first doses of charcoal are going to contain a cathartic like sorbitol. That's going to kind of help push everything through the system. Depending on how the animal is doing, how much chocolate they ingested, they may need to repeat that dose of charcoal every 4 to 6 hours for 3 to 4 doses. Most of the patients, you decontaminate, give one dose of charcoal, they go home and do fine. But in the hospital, you may need to repeat that. The treatment for chocolate toxicity, if they do need to stay in the hospital, is really symptomatic. So if they have a really high heart rate, if they're having GI signs, treat them for that. If they're having seizures, treat that with Valium. Beta blockers are really common to treat the cardiac. So if they have really, you know, extremely high tachycardia, propranolol is one of the most common ones. Give it slowly, watch the ECG, make sure that you're seeing that heart rate drop slowly and not all of a sudden. IV fluids are really important for diuresis, for cardiac output support, for blood pressure support. Some of these guys can have a really high blood pressure as well, so just make sure that we're monitoring all of their vitals. Providing some GI support, depending on how they're doing with that, monitor them for pancreatitis, abdominal pain, that type of thing. And then the methylxanthines are actually reabsorbed through the bladder wall. So some very severely chocolate toxicity patients may need a urinary catheter placed so that we can keep their bladder empty and they stop reabsorbing that. This is important to know if you're sending an animal home after ingesting chocolate, to tell the owners to walk them frequently so that their bladder stays empty. A patient in your hospital that doesn't have a urinary catheter, maybe you walk them every 2 hours so that they're not just continuing to reabsorb those toxins. The methylxanthines do have a long half-life, so they may be up to 72 hours that the patient is going to be experiencing these signs from the toxicity, so they may need to stay in the hospital for a while. You treat them until they're asymptomatic. Treat them until their heart rate returns to normal, until their blood pressure is normal, until their mentation is normal. Support their GI signs. Some of these guys may be in the hospital longer just because of the vomiting and diarrhea. So once they're all better, a lot of these patients return home to a completely normal life. And those are the basics on chocolate toxicity.